Yeah, I invited a few people just off label. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Well, let me know when you want me to put up the sign that tells them. So, welcome everybody. I'm David, it's my house. And I'm excited to have Ellie and Mary playing here. Ellie's an old friend of mine, and we hike together pretty much every week.
Place I used to live and make music, and I'm so glad we get to perform live together after a really long hiatus. So my program is called the Greek Chamber Music Project. It's a project I've been doing for more than a decade now, celebrating the Greek world through the rich language of chamber music. And so I've done many different programs within it. This one is a more intimate project. We're looking at the past for inspiration for this program, looking at poetry and song about past places and past loves. And it's a very Hellenic experience, but it's also a very human experience. And so I, you know, curated this program with all those kind of ideas in mind. So the first piece is one of my own originals called Words of Grief. And here we go.
Thank you.
What's done is done, so grief we take, calming our heart for duty's sake. So as I mentioned, this was my own composition. It was originally meant to accompany a series of translations about war and grief from Homer, from the Iliad in particular. It was a collaboration I did at San Francisco State University's Classics program a couple years ago. And I actually, the whole concert was my own chamber music accompaniments, my own arrangements to the singer-songwriter Joe Goodkin, who sings and strums his way through original songs about the Odyssey and the Iliad. So anyway, this was an interlude to that whole program, which is really fun. It also appears on my latest album, Synchronos, New Greek Voices, but also with the sounds of guitar, cello, and violin. The next piece we're going to play, is by Evangelos Kokoris, who is a composer and a flute player based in Greece. The piece is called Pensieri Peduti, which means lost thoughts in Italian, and I asked him to share what inspired him to write this piece. And he said that Pensieri Peduti contains fragments of memory, lost thoughts, and nostalgic chimeras that leave traces in our world. After all, the importance of memory lies in liberating us, not diminishing our thoughts, but in extending them beyond desire, beyond the future, as well as from the past.
Thank you.
So next up, Mary will play some solo piano music by Greek musical legend Manos Hadzidakis. These are a couple movements from his six popular pictures. They're these rich and expressive interpretations of old Greek songs, especially ones in the blues-esque tradition of Rembetiko. She actually just completed her dissertation on Hadzidakis piano music. Congratulations, Mary. Quite an accomplishment. And you can hear this and more on her solo album tribute to Hadzidakis, which we have for sale. It's called The Moon is Red, a tribute to Manos Hadzidakis. She's going to play two movements. She's going to play Cloudy Sunday, which is, I would say, Greece's unofficial national anthem. And it's got kind of a positive, you know, major key sound to it, but it actually has sort of darker undertones because it was written in response to police brutality. And the second movement that she's going to do is The Night Fell Without a Moon. And the original lyrics for that song, for the original Rembetiko song, are about a young man who is up at night with worry. And I thought that this poem by C.P. Kavafi would pair nicely with the mood for that second movement. This is called The Windows. Within these darkened rooms where I abide, from day to dismal day I wearily stride. I'm searching for the windows when, at last, one opens, it will offer some relief. There are no windows such that I can tell. I found not one, perhaps it's just as well. They might only impart future grief. Who knows what other things it might forecast? Thank you.
that come from? Sorry.
That's great. You're by yourself with the music.
Right? Not am I practicing or something?
Piece for you for this first half, this first set. This is a world premiere by my friend Michael Malice, who is a composer, educator, and jazz pianist based in Detroit, also Greek-American. This piece is called Thymisu Soma, which in Greek means body, remember body. And it's originally composed for mezzo-soprano with a bilingual libretto. So it switches back between Greek and English, which very much speaks to our Greek-American experience. He kindly reimagined this piece for flute, and that's what you're hearing today. But before we play it, I'm gonna read you the original poem in Greek and then in English. Soma, thymisu όχι μόνο το πόσο αγαπήθηκες, όχι μονάχα τα κρεβάτια που αποπλάγιασες, αλλά και εκείνες τις επιθυμίες που για σένα
Jalisan mesta matia fanera. Και τρέμανε μες στη φωνή και κάποιο τυχαίο εμπόδιο τες ματέωσε. Τώρα που είναι όλα πια μες στο παρελθόν, μοιάζει σχεδόν και στις επιθυμίες εκείνες σαν να δόθηκες. Πώς γυάλιζαν, θυμίσου μες στα μάτια που σε κοίταζαν, πώς έτρεμαν μες στη φωνή για σε. Thimisu soma. Body, remember not only how much you were loved, not only the beds on which you lay, but also those desires for which for you plainly glowed in the eyes and trembled in the voice, and some chance obstacle made them futile. Now that all belongs to the past, it is almost as if you had yielded to those desires. Remember how they glowed in the eyes looking at you, how they trembled in the voice for you. Remember, body.
Thank you.
we're going to take about a 10-minute break, have some wine, some nibbles, come chat with us, come and check out our CDs and our merchandise, and we'll come back for some more music.
That phone says low battery.
Oh, that phone.
Should we try to plug it in somewhere?
Yeah. Let me turn down the volume on that. just ready.
Increase its margin.
Maybe I'll just talk a little about the piece. So, hello. For the second half, we're focusing on songs, many of them arrangements of our own, of old songs kind of reinterpreted in our own voices. Mary is, of course, both an accomplished pianist, but she's also a singer, and that's such a treat. Our recordings that we've done together have included a mix of instrumental music and also some of these songs, which is really wonderful.
There's an echo in here.
Get some technical things going on here with the stream. Thank you all for bearing with us. Okay, so this next song is called Paper Moon. It's by Manos Hadzidakis. You heard some of his instrumental music on the first half, and this is one of his songs. It's thinking of pining for love and nostalgia, and it's just a really treasured piece.
Thank you.
next song is by another famous Greek composer, a contemporary of Hatzidakis. His name is Mikis Theodorakis. He was known both as a composer and also an activist around the world. This piece is called Omorphi Poli, which means beautiful, beautiful city. I'm going to read a poem for you by Kavafi that I think beautifully captures the mood here. In the same space, in the surroundings of home, of nightclubs and neighborhoods, which I've seen and where I've walked for year upon year, I have created you in times of joy and at times in sorrow, out of so many experiences, out of so many occurrences. And you, the whole of you, have become utter feeling for me. One of the gods does wreck me out on the drunken sea. I have a heart that is inured to suffering, and I shall steel it to endure that too. For in my day I have had many bitter and painful experiences in war and on the stormy seas. So let this new disaster come. It only makes one more. This next song is called Vast Sea, Thalassat Latia, and so I paired it with this excerpt from the Odyssey by Homer. Falasaplatya is about, it's really a love song, but it's also about the rocky seas and the rocky, I think, relationship that this person has with their love. Anyway, it's a really, really touching song. It's one of my favorites of Mary's arrangements. This next piece is a song about displacement, about longing for a homeland far away. It appeared on a program I premiered earlier this year titled Uproot, to commemorate the 100-year anniversary of the Asia Minor catastrophe, where Hellenic people were expelled from Asia Minor, also known as Anatolia. And the refrain for this next song is "Sky, Send Me a Bird." If this concert were an album, this would be the title track. So before we go into that piece, I'm going to also read another Kavafi poem that I feel like captures this longing for a homeland far away. This is called Before Time Changed Them. They were both deeply saddened at their parting. It wasn't their doing, but rather the circumstances. The need to earn a living required one of them to travel far away, New York or Canada. Their love wasn't certainly
the same as it once had been. The attraction between them had slowly diminished. The attraction between them had diminished quite a bit. And yet parting like this wasn't what they wanted. It was the circumstances, or perhaps it was fate. Become an artist that required them to part before time had changed them, before their feelings failed. So that now one for the other will always remain as though he were still a handsome young man of 24. Program comes to a close. Thank you all so much for coming. Thank you to David for hosting us for this group news. Thank you to everybody streaming, tuning in from around the country and beyond. This last piece was also on our Uproot program called So Long, Virgin Mary. So in Greek, Echeia Panagia.
It's a traditional song from Anatolia, and the lyrics mostly talk about different neighborhoods around Constantinople, and the refrain is mostly about remembering and then forgetting. So that's just kind of how the past and memory seem to work sometimes, and very much, I think, neatly ties up our theme for today's concert. Anyway, we have, you know, CDs for sale, merchandise. Please sign up for my mailing list. I have more concerts planned for the fall, so yeah, just thank you all for being here.
So
with you guys afterward, and I'm just honored to be able to share this music with you.
So usually we have kind of a Q&A afterwards. If anybody wants to. Sophia,
Had a question. How often do you do this? Although I believe you kind of answered that earlier.
Oh no, I just sort of alluded to it. It's a good question. I did a project, another tour. The last couple pieces were part of that program in February, and then I have another program in November. So yeah, about every few months, a couple times a year, something like that. It's a very like niche project, but I'm always trying to find new angles and new collaborations within it. So yeah, great questions.
Well, I have a whole question about the history.
Fantastic.
Because you said about the people being driven out.
Yes.
And where were they driven out of? Where were they driven to? And how does this relate to the Turks? Genocide of Armenia.
It's related as the Turkish nation was developing. They were expelling Christian populations, Greek people of Hellenic descent, and also Armenians around that same period. And this was about a century ago. And so because the Asia Minor catastrophe, which happened at the expulsion in 1922 is when that happened, that's kind of a centennial for the Hellenic people. And for the people that survived, they ended up in modern-day Greece, and Greece's population swelled to 20% as a result of that. And actually, what I didn't share during the program is that Mary and I both have descendants from Asia Minor. So we have a sort of personal connection to that history.
Do you have family in Greece?
I do, yeah. My dad is native Greek person.
As she mentioned, with the population increasing, right? As with any influx of refugees, when a social infrastructure cannot support that kind of influx of people, right? There are issues of crime and there are drugs that turn up, and this is how this form of music came to be, this kind of style of singing. It's a little more guttural, as you can hear. It's a bar kind of singing. It's built in taverns, in hashish dens. It's called rebetika music. What Ellie is doing is carrying on the tradition, which Theodorakis and Hatilakis started, which was to combine this style of like lower class street music with the upper echelon ideals of classical music. So it's really beautiful what she's continuing on.
Interesting. Thank you. Thanks, Mary. Other questions?
So Mary, you arranged these. What were your sources for these arrangements?
So the ones that I arranged were the first. on the album you'll see a lot more on two of the albums. They are originally Hatzidakis' songs, except for the one Theodorakis song. Hatzidakis spent the remainder of his life. At the end of his life, he had like six periods of composition, and the sixth period he spent desperately trying to give new music a front in Athens, right, and across the world, honestly, but to show that he was not just this composer of Never on Sunday, which is unfortunately what he is known for, is that song, right?
The soundtrack for this film from the 60s.
Yeah. That song won an Academy Award, and he actually tried to turn down the Academy Award because he was like, I don't want this to be my legacy.
What was the film?
Never on Sunday. It's about the prostitute.
You're just right? A little too young.
So the reason why I chose to rewrite those songs, though, and if you listen to the albums, I did them also, a few tracks are in English as well, because I wanted to be related across audiences. And I also incorporated a lot of extended techniques on piano, because I wanted to keep the tradition that Kazilakis was trying to do with his Athenian experimental orchestra that he founded at the end of his life, by having this kind of modern technique into music. I rewrote the pieces because I feel like I rearranged them because I feel like it is what he would have wanted those pieces to be, because they are beautiful pieces of poetry. And if you want to learn more about Hatzidakis, he actually wrote books upon poetry that are just, it's beautifully eloquent. It's hard to translate into English because when you try to, you stumble across words that are repeated over and over again, and some Greek words don't really work in English, you know, but I'm hoping I translate at least the feeling of those within the songs.
Yeah. The last two were arrangements for my Uproot project. One of them was actually arranged by Michael Malice, who had composed Thimi Susoma. I had him do that arrangement for me. That was Fegari Maya Mukanes. And then Ehi Yabaniai was my own arrangement. And yeah, just sort of a hybrid of a sort of, it's a folk song, right? It's the only piece on the program that doesn't have a composer attached to it. It's sort of just an oral tradition. But I wanted to keep the essence of it, but bring it into the language of, you know, the instruments we play and the you know, traditions with, you know, contemporary classical music. So, yeah, anyway, great questions.
It's a little rock and roll what she did. You should know that. Because that's, it's not, it's again, it's like bringing, she's continuing the tradition of bringing that lower echelon to the upper, and it's a little, like if we're going over the pronunciations, and like, from where I'm from in Greece, you would say ga for certain things, and like, where this song is from, the woman who sings it, right, in the original track is saying ga, which is a little bit controversial, right?
So Galata versus Galata, which is a town. Yeah, it's got a more, it's more guttural, as you say. Yeah, a little harsher. Yeah.
You were at a rock and roll show, you just didn't know.
Cool.
Any other? In Greek music, the kind of the modern concert flute has, you know, has been used to portray the music of many different cultures, right? And bring
for
it
sure.
into kind of Western classical traditions.
For sure.
Is there kind of like a more specifically Greek flute?
Not in the traditional sense. Well, I would say that in the cities in like Constantinople and Smyrna, which in modern day Turkey are Istanbul and Izmir, these cities that had a lot of Hellenic people had their own little orchestras that would play in cabarets and so on. And so flute tended to be part of that, right? Beyond that, I don't think flute is so common in kind of more relatively recent Greek history. But what I'll hear is, you know, growing up, I used to go to Greece in the summers and hear, you know, outdoor concerts. For fuller orchestrations of some of this music, you would hear flute as well as, you know, violin, you know, strings and other kinds of instruments that adds sort of a, you know, a complexity to it. But it's not as traditional as you might think.
Is that a landline?
We've gone back in time.
In some more ways than one.
I have one more question. When I think of Greek music, of course, I think of Yannis Xenakis.
Oh, yeah.
And did he write anything that you could play in the flute?
There's one piece, I think, that I'm familiar with. Yeah. Xenakis is quite hard. but Mary is up to the challenge.
I've done some Xenakis before. Yeah.
What?
I've done some Xenakis before.
Really?
And in fact, Xenakis won the... very first, I want to say, of one of Hadzidakis' modern composition competitions, which is the reason why he has his career. So I just want to, again, one more Hadzidakis for the win. Yes. I'm a big proponent.
Cool.
Thank you.
Okay, so everybody's welcome to hang out and have more wine or spani kopita.
Amazing.
Whatever.
Thank you, David.
That's a good pronunciation.
So one more hand for
you. Oh, thank you.